Greetings, fellow earthlings. Welcome to Mirror's Edge Catalyst. Now, before I begin, I would just like to make something clear that this is not a sequel or a prequel or in any way, shape, or form connected to Mirror's Edge, the original Mirror's Edge title from 2008, or maybe it was 6, I don't recall exactly. But it is more or less a reboot of the franchise, which is something that sort of pissed me off when I found out about that, because this was supposed to be I was hoping this would be a sequel at least. At any rate, EA actually teamed up with Dark Horse Comics and they released a series of comics called Mirror's Edge Exordium, which more or less outlines the prequel, or not exactly the prequel, but the prologue to how things came to be in Mirror's Edge Catalyst. And well, once I play the game for you, you'll realize that Faith wakes up in the Kreuger security, or rather, jail cell. And, what essentially happened was Faith, she got caught up in a deal. She actually more or less interrupted a deal. Faith interrupted a deal between two, you know, mob parties, and one of them held her accountable. So, the mob boss called Dogen got enamored by his spirit and decided that she should, instead of killing her, she should work off the amount of money that she apparently lost Dogen. And what Faith also noticed was a painting that her mother used to work on when she was a child. And see, she essentially wanted to purchase that painting from Dogen as well. So they decided on an arbitrary number of jobs for Faith to complete. At the same time, Faith in this story does not have any other family. She does not have a sister Kate or her father. She instead has a foster father called Noah, who runs his own running cabal. And Noah had no idea that Faith was running for Dogen. And things ultimately kept escalating to a point until where Dogen told her to break into Krugersec, and that is Kruger security, and essentially steal a random vial. And set the lab on fire. Now, Faith went to do that, but turns out that the vial was already stolen, and she had to escape by the skin of her teeth. She met Cell, who in this game is from yet another cabal, and one day she goes to Cell's hideout and realizes that Cell actually has the vial that Dogen told her to steal. Now, Faith's dilemma here is the fact that that vial is actually cancer medicine that is, you know, gonna help Cell's sister. However, I mean, that's like one incentive for her not to steal it. However, if she does decide to steal it, she will be outcast from all of the, you know, runner groups, because runners in this edition of the game do not steal from each other. So now she actually tries stealing the vial, and her conscience gets the better of it, so she returns the vial to Cell. Krugersec are already, you know, hot on their tail. They only know that there's like one runner that's running about the place. So she hands the vial over to Cell and turns herself in so that Cell can return to her sister and continue curing her. So that is how she ends up in jail. And her foster father, Noah, realizes what's really going on. You know, that she's working for Dogen, and he confronts Dogen and tells her to settle all debts, basically. And that is how Faith found herself in the Kreuger jail cell. Now, I have prattled on for long enough. I would make some commentary about Exordium and the original Mirror's Edge comics as well, which serve as a prologue to the original Mirror's Edge, but we'll do all of that, like draw comparisons and provide commentary on it after this video. So with that being said, I have already played this game twice now, as in I haven't completed it, but the following sections that you're about to see, I have already completed them twice now. I wasn't satisfied with the first time, and the second time the audio recording turned out to be very poor in quality, so I decided that I might as well start off with a new game. So that's exactly what I'm about to do right now. So here we go.
I got my hands on a glitch mod which should work with your.
And this is how you need to start off a new game, like it's hidden away in the options menu. In the city of class, the conglomerate ruled supreme. All regular citizens had been made willing slaves, lured into an endless race for status and wealth. But some choose to live off the grid. So, in both of these comics, there is a citizenship program. Runners, workers, couriers, and cat burglars, the rooftops belong to them as long as they don't openly challenge the authorities, the conglomerate turns a blind eye. So corporations essentially overtook the government and they enrolled a citizenship program where for almost 2 decades the status quo has held, where only people who register themselves as citizens are allowed to live inside the city. Times are about to change, and that's pretty much the entire reason why.
For you, Dogen. But Noah can't know.
You owe me a lot of script, Faith. I expect you to deliver on your promise.
Every new day holds a promise. You waste it or spend it advancing yourself. Furthering your prospects and your career. As a future employee of a corporation of your choice, your possibilities are infinite. The key to success lies in unlocking your inner potential through hard work and relentless dedication. As an employee, you are expected to perform at the top of your abilities.
Last day, huh?
And constantly strive to
excel. I thought we'd keep you here forever, Leech.
Work is rewarded.
Maybe you'd like another 3 months.
Laziness punished.
It would be so easy.
Personal freedom comes at a
Come
price.
Come on, let's go. We got a full day ahead.
Our great society expects every employee to contribute to the corporation of their choice.
Has served a 12-month sentence, to which 9 months were added for several incidents of insubordination. Deemed ready for
conditional release.
Now, if it was up to me...
Policy exists to keep you safe. Be wary of policy breakers in our midst.
Upon release, you must
seek immediate employment and will be monitored through your grid link.
If you do not find employment within 14 days, you'll be relocated to a Greenland facility. Do you understand these conditions?
Just get me out of here.
Work hard and you will be rewarded.
Dressing rooms to the left, Leech.
And enjoy riches well-deserved.
Dogen sends his best. Enjoy your freedom.
Which is why running is illegal, but yeah, this is how the game literally starts at this point right here. And yeah, the game does lag every now and then. I have installed something which might potentially be a fix. So I'm just gonna walk here, because there are these guards right here, you know? So Faith was essentially imprisoned for, only sentenced for 3 months, not 12, but as you heard, 9 months were added to a sentence because of whatever reason. The graphics in this game still do blow my mind. We can run now. Or can't we? This is, by the way, very graphical.
Hey! Over here! Don't get on that bus. Follow me.
For whatever reason, that wind always comes back.
I'm Icarus. Noah sent me.
You could be anyone.
Well, you'll just have to trust me. Here, take this. I want to get off the streets.
A beat link? But...
Put it on. We need to get you connected and calibrated. I know Noah's eager to talk to you.
What the hell?
Come on, we need to get moving. You need
it. Are you back and driving? Price and auto is the end. Ah, there's something wrong with this.
So, in the comics, Faith actually never used Beatlink. For whatever reason, nobody actually, they never told us why, but she never really used Beatlink.
Oh, sorry, almost forgot. We have to cut your grid link. It's causing the interference.
Is this what the employees see all the time?
Yeah, I guess you're not reformed enough to enjoy it.
I'm not reformed at all.
There you go. You're off the grid. Now they know you're gone. Time to get off the ground.
Out of jail and right back into crime. So let me just go ahead and... Right, so we're back and... So in this game, the parkour is like super smooth.
He said we'll catch us both if we stick around. I'll go the other way, meet you up ahead.
Noah, so if you,
she's out. I gave her the B-link and she's off the grid.
So if you hold down space in this game.
Noah?
It's good to hear your voice, but keep moving. We need to get K-Sec off your tail.
Indeed.
Easier said than done, Noah. They seem hell-bent on finding her. God is covered. Faith should be coming up on her own warehouse soon. Get inside and we'll take it from there.
Yeah, we got her control. Nah, I can handle it. Submit!
These guys always go submit. Oof. So they don't actually tell you how to open doors. You need to figure that out for yourself.
Okay, I made it inside. Can someone tell me what the hell is going on?
They were gonna send you to a Greyland food dome, Faith. We had to get you now. Cutting your grid link makes you a fugitive, but we planned for this. Follow the runner echo through the warehouse. Icarus will meet up with you on the other side. By then, you should be in the clear.
If you can make it through that old place, time to see if the fabled Faith is all that she's made out to be.
Nobody likes a smart mouth, Icarus. She'll do fine. Oh, your B-Link will calibrate as you go, Faith.
So, yeah, like I said, Faith actually never used a B-Link in the comics.
There's a general search warrant out for Phoenix Carpenter, female, young, facial tattoo. They're a bit more insistent than I expected. Phoenix Carpenter? Yeah, Dogen set her up with a fake grid print when they took her. I transferred it to her B-Link as insurance. Might come in handy later.
Indeed.
A VTOL just flew in. I think K-Sec means business.
Just keep going.
Just keep going indeed. Alright, so here we are. How about now?
This is a change since you were taken, Faith. Kruger's sec are coming down hard on even the tiniest policy infractions.
Yes, they are. Yes,
yeah,
they are.
Easy being a regular employee these days. I almost pity them.
They made their choice long ago, Icarus.
So, one of the negatives of this game... I keep forgetting to do that. Yeah.
Control. I got Carpenter. Submit.
Oh, so I need to fight this guy. I tend to keep forgetting that I actually need to fight this guy before I can go ahead and open this door.
I asked nicely, but he wouldn't step aside.
And now they know you came this way.
Like I had a choice.
Sure. We need to clear out. Better take a different route to the Everdyne Tower. We'll split up again, keep them confused. Can you make it across to those pipes?
Of course.
Good. Your B-Link should be calibrated by now and your runner's vision working. Just follow the red and I'll meet you at the tower. Let's go.
What's happening to this guy's shoot? I mean, that's something that never happened before. Whatever reason... I said the graphics, what the fuck? Right. So whatever reason, I actually said the graphics lower than I did previously. But the game's still lagging quite a lot. I've heard that it happens because...
Really?
Here we are. Almost her. So apparently there are lags in this game because the game tries to keep saving data onto your disk.
Sent her on a different route to the tower. K-Sec blocked the intersection. Okay, good. I'm working on a little something once you get there. Faith, you're headed for an office building under construction. It's a good place to shake 'em.
Excuse me? Why is it so hard today? I already did it like twice yesterday, but for whatever reason, I can't do it today. Here we are. There we go. I have no idea why it took so long. And you also need to like learn your skills. You can't really, you know. You don't really know everything from the very beginning. There's like an RPG mechanic in this game, and it's open world.
K-Sec just dropped several squads into Everdyne Tower. Damn it. Okay, we can handle this. Faith, get to the Orion building nearby. Icarus meter there.
Moving.
So the parkour is definitely smoother, but that's about it. Come on.
There are K-Sec everywhere.
Indeed.
Zip line leading to Orion. I'm at Orion. Good. Keep going, Faith.
So I tried running along the walls in this section. It doesn't really work.
I think I lost them.
For now.
You did, for now. 6 2 years in prison only made you better at this.
So all these things are mostly to make sure that you maintain your momentum and nothing else. A door that is not in red. You can open these doors here.
Oh, at least you got here before dawn.
Who's Tom?
Who are you, anyway? When did you join the Cabal?
About a year ago.
Well, I grew up with them. So how about you cut me some damn slack?
You also got caught and caused a whole lot of trouble for Noah.
You don't know what happened.
I know enough. And I know that I'm faster and safer than you.
Faith.
I'm here. It's a bit crowded with new guy and his ego.
Knock it off, both of you. Look, we are out of options. The only way out is through the Everdyne Tower. And with K-Sec there, you're gonna have to fight them. Icarus, upload the combat mod to Faith's beamlink.
Alright, done.
Good. Faith, use the mod to freshen up your fighting skills before you go on. I was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but looks like we don't have any choice.
Don't worry, Noah. I can do it.
I know you can.
At least in this game, it's like pretty.
The mod sets up a few enemy echoes to scatter. There's a bit of happiness.
Yes. Impressive for a.
I can track your metrics from here, Faith. Alright, let's get started. Be creative. Vary your attacks. Or K-Sec will anticipate you and strike back. And even better, of course, is if you knock them into one another. Two for one.
What the fuck? I'm just trying to figure out the reach right now, but yeah.
Alright, K-Sec comms have calmed down a little, but they know you're out there somewhere, Faith. And they know you'll have to go through the tower to get out. And the streets are not an option? We never go to ground if we can avoid it, you know that, Icarus. Yeah, I know.
So at least like even the tutorial is pretty immersive in this game.
Just right, Faith. Keep it up.
Oh wait, that way? I think so, yeah.
Remember to use your surroundings when attacking.
I miss that every single time. It's supposed to be a crotch kick. Indeed.
Why? What difference would that make? Read up on the Connors family history and you'll get why, Icarus. Fighting echoes now, but there are real enemies waiting for you ahead. Don't underestimate them, Faith.
I'm ready, Noah.
You always were a fierce fighter, Faith. You'll be fine.
They're leaving a lot less space for me to actually commentate. A lot of dialogue. Excuse me? What the fuck do you mean on the ground?
I'm inside.
You can do this, Faith.
Yeah. Here goes.
Please advise.
One more thing. K-Sec are talking about some special unit being sent in. It could be a new drone or something. Be careful, both of you.
We got a runner here.
Come on, jump over. Exactly. Poor guy probably died. Fighting me, I mean. Like, even the combat in this game is quite fluid and smooth.
Underneath, now!
When it's not like,
Should we call for backup?
She shouldn't be.
Well, guess who is? Well, that worked out, I suppose. In a manner of speaking. That way? Yeah, that way. Funny thing is, we need to like come back here anyway. After what happens up ahead. I dislike the fact that the game is lagging so hard, but what can we do here? That wasn't me, by the way. Well, apparently she did.
Don't.
No vitals. Then she's dead. Let the cleanup crew dig up the body. I got better things to do.
Do you know?
She took out all of them. Send an EMT too while you're at it. I'm done here.
That was like a pretty weird landing, to be honest. She felt quite weightless in that landing of hers. Like, if this game would stop lagging for like a minute, things would be much better. Like this instance right here.
Calls. You did really well, Faith.
Yeah, that thing, I don't really know what that thing is, but whatever that is.
Guess I shouldn't be so surprised you got K-Sec so upset. It is your specialty after all.
Yeah, so like I already told you guys.
Watchful for that special unit in the future. Seems they've improved their combat training.
So she essentially went into K-Sec. She had been messing around with K-Sec for quite a long time now, but she essentially stole a vial from K-Sec. Is why Noah tells her that K-Sec is essentially a specialty.
While you were away. You'll find us in the Zephyr Transit Hub.
So even things like the Krypton, I need to purchase it. I need to unlock it by purchasing it first. I don't have any of it right now. I need to like manually turn around and look using the mouse. If the game keeps lagging, I'll probably have to change the settings again. And there it is, Mirror's Edge Catalyst. I wonder why it's called Catalyst though. Solitaire.
Come on home.
Focus shield. Yeah. You can like give yourself like a running start in this game, no need to. Particularly build up momentum. You also build up momentum quite fast in this game, so that's another thing.
Catch up with you later, Noah. Sounds good, Icarus. We still have a game to finish. When you get closer, you'll know the marks, Faith. Just follow them home. And then we should see about getting you reintroduced to the world. I got a run for you that should do the trick.
Fresh out of jail and right into another run. That's where we are. Really? Apparently that was the name of the mission, release, and it has been completed. I wonder what sound there though. And back there. Interesting. Well, I do not enter, to be honest. That's the objective marker you can see to the sky. There are some runners practicing here. See, this is how you do it. Indeed. There's nothing back there, by the way, I already checked. She can run in this game. Faith, I mean.
Entryway accessible. Yeah, let me see that from 3D. Right. And that's where you're going to want to go up to the fourth floor. Okay, and that's where the access point's going to be.
What's the beat?
I heard some runner got out of juvie today.
I heard she's eager to run.
She's been gone a long time.
I also heard she's sorry.
Maybe she learned something while she was away.
Maybe. I'm so sorry. You look older.
Screw you.
Nice place you got here.
Yeah.
Mind if I stay a while?
I was hoping you would.
And about that run?
Go talk to Birdman. He'll put you through your paces.
New guy. Seems a bit uptight.
Hey, Chris?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's a good kid. He runs better than anyone.
Than anyone?
Go talk to Birdman, and we'll see. I'll be here.
Dogen sent me a greeting.
Yeah. We'll deal with him in time. All right. Now go. Astound me.
Maybe I will. Maybe I will. But yeah, you've got like a huge multiplayer aspect to this game. Now,
my clothes.
Nomad brought them here just after you were caught. I've upgraded your beat with a map mod of glass. You'll need it to get around and to find the smaller.
I'm sorry. Looks like I'm gonna have to purchase the thing right now. Can't really do anything without it. So it more or less helps me keep track of, you know.
Runs spread out across the city.
Yeah, right. Just give me a moment there. Okay, so maybe that should help with the game. Who knows, really. So essentially, you get all these
good to see you back, Faith.
Multiplayer stuff, run attack emblem, which you have to customize on mirrorsearch.com because of the online component. And whenever this game starts saving, the game actually does lag a little bit. Nothing that can be done about it.
It's been a long time. Let's catch up later.
Really? Oh, the game already remembers from when I tagged this thing. And has all the runner kits as well. Wait a minute, there's a basic kit back there. Right here. I wonder what's in it though. A good Cascadian follows the rules. Okay. Escape with a kit from an old enemy. Now, I just want to quickly check out what you know, stuff my character has. There's this thing. Chaos Line Dread. Alright. That works, I suppose. I'm getting like 30 goddamn FPS. I really don't want to play this. The game takes a while loading in all the textures. The game is pretty heavy as well, so can't really blame it for doing that, but yeah. Wait, not here. Right, I need to first set the destination for Birdman's place. There's another one there, but we'll pick it up. Here we are.
Birdman will be glad to see you. He's one of the few things that hasn't changed at all.
This is a fragile delivery thing. I guess it has not unlocked yet. Otherwise, should have told us something.
There you are. What do you want?
Oh, just a look at you. While you're still in one piece. Dogen expects prompt payment, you know.
And he'll get it.
Yes. Yes, he will. Now run along.
So that's the part which sort of confuses me about the game. Fate's foster father Noah back there, he actually confronted Dogen and
so
told him to lay off.
And she doesn't even come to visit?
Who would?
Hey Nomad, how's it going?
Way better now that you're out, and it just so happens that I could also use your help.
I'm on my way to Birdman.
Yeah, I heard. I say that geezer can wait, but it's your choice. Check your map for where to find me.
Yeah, so what we're gonna do first is we're gonna go ahead and meet this guy first. Old friends. Like I said, I've already completed this mission once, but yeah, it's... Oh, wait, that's a main mission? No. Let's go ahead and complete Birdman's side missions first. We need to get up there. No way here. A runner on a mission, and those guys are practicing the wall runs. I mean, it makes you sort of want to flex on them, you know? So I really like the open world aspect of this game. Excuse me. So, if you can hear that, that's essentially a runner pack, and they still have maintained that system from the original Mirror's Edge. And here it is. It's a secret bag. I like the fact that they actually chime like that. By the way, right now she actually moves on all fours. Okay. Follow the red. Noah sent you to talk to Birdman, one of the first runners in the city and an old friend. Supposedly he has a few hoops for you to jump through in order to prove your skill. Accept.
Easy there. Leave my door alone. Patience never was your virtue, Faith.
Thought you were taking a nap. Isn't what old people do?
Careful with that mouth, girl. I guess 2 years of peace and quiet is all I get.
Yeah, I missed you too.
Noah wanted me to test you. I told him I'd do no such thing. But I have a dash for you. Enough to test yourself.
So that's good.
I already fed you, Calliope. Get off of me. Damn rats with wings. Never leave me alone. But they have their uses.
Patience never was your virtue.
True. That's why I can smell my own. Now off with you. Show them other runners that you've got your uses too. It's good to have you back, girl.
Right, so this first side mission is essentially a dash.
I can imagine which one. Man, back in the day I ran it so many times I could even blindfold it.
Excuse me? What the fuck just happened there? I was trying to get onto this rope line here, but apparently the game thought I should dash instead.
One more thing, Faith. The marked route is not always the best one. You only need to reach the goal in the shortest time possible. The way you take doesn't matter.
Dash. Runners have created quick paths all around the city. Run them as fast as you can, taking shortcuts if possible, and compete on the leaderboards. No, actually, I haven't figured out any shortcuts for this dash right here. So I'm just going to be doing whatever I can. Holy shit. Totally missed that. Here we go. Come on. Speed is, of course, the essence. The name of the game here. Open up. And looks like we could not beat our old time. Probably because we fell down there again. Like, fell down there in that thing. Right.
I see your dash time is up on the beat, Faith. Not bad. Glad to see you still got it.
Yeah, so now we can actually go ahead and purchase an upgrade. So first upgrade that I would like to purchase is probably quick turn. Or maybe skill roll. I don't really know. Left control, hold close to the point of impact. During slide to quickly roll out of it. I see. Roll out of a landing or slide to retain high momentum and gain focus shield. Hold close to the point of impact. Shift during slide to quickly roll out of it. I see. So quick turn I feel like might be useful. So I'm just going to go ahead and purchase that. And then we can...
Of data got scattered all over the city, and now it's leaking through the grid. Please tap into any leaks you see, and we'll get that data reassembled.
Roger. Oh, no, not you. That is a main mission. I do not want to do a main mission right now. I want to return to Birdman. That's where I want to go. I was wondering, how is Birdman so close? He wasn't supposed to be so close. It's sort of sad that you really need to... Wait, what's that? I do believe I've picked it up before.
I thought I'd document our trip like a diary. Can't wait for when she gets older.
She's doing much better already.
Yeah, but she's still really weak. I don't expect her to remember much of the journey.
We're almost down to the supply list. Firebird's still looking into transportation. We'll need a dependable vehicle.
You're right. And I didn't expect that part to be easy.
Maybe Black November can help out.
I'd rather have as little to do with them as possible. We got the guns. That's more than enough. I'm gonna check on the van. Let me know when the supplies are done.
Excuse me.
Got it.
So Black November is an extremist group. And quick turn. Oh yeah, I did have quick turn, didn't I? I could just run up the wall instead. Didn't need to do all that. Sort of forgot I had quick turn, at any rate. Yeah, let's talk to Birdman. Messenger girl, Birdman has a delivery run for you. These form the backbone of the runner trade, and it's a simple but effective way to deliver information while avoiding conglomerate scrutiny.
You're back. Remember, in this community, you're only as good as people think you are. No matter how good you actually are. It's a bit silly, all this peacocking. Posturing.
Felt great running.
And you did good time, too. One thing left and we're done.
Noah said something about a delivery?
Bread and butter of our trade. I happen to have a small package I need dropped off. You can pick it up over there.
What is that, by the way? There's like messenger girl. Oh, okay. That's where I need to drop the package. Got it. So this is like a timed event.
These days, all packages are beat linked, so you should see the delivery point on your map. I
I remember those days as well, because I played Mirror's Edge first. Oh, you can actually slide down pipes like that now. That's interesting. That is really interesting. I did not think that was possible. Looks like we're getting at this place right here. And that ruined our momentum. By quite a large margin, actually. Alright, come on. Get up there. And here we are.
I just got confirmation that the package has been delivered, Faith. Seems to me you're as ready as you'll ever be. And yes, I too have a beat link now. Prefer not to use it much. You never can tell who's listening in.
Understandable. Right then. So we head back to Birdman now and see what mission he has for us now. Thing is, I haven't done this mission by Birdman yet. Look at it just bashing through doors. Hold up that way? Yeah, that way. We still don't have skill roll yet. I keep forgetting that. Why even call it skill roll though? I mean, it's supposed to be like a very inherent part of Mirror's Edge. Am I gonna have to work a bit to get that? Yes, I am. How is it that Faith can run so well, but she does not know how to roll out of a dive? There are lots of collectibles in this game. Lots of them. So when you stop running, you essentially lose all the momentum. And your momentum essentially protects you from hits. Protects you against hits from other soldiers. Well, that did nothing. Come on. This game can be a little finicky sometimes. Oh, by the way, she crawls on all fours now, in case I haven't told you guys that yet. Here we are, another mission for Birdman. Pigeon Sound, Errato. Birdman used to be running, and he's seen Cascadia transform under conglomerate tyranny. He might be a grumpy old bastard, but he's always been there for you. And that counts for something in the city. If he needs help, it's definitely worthwhile checking out what he needs doing. Alright.
Hey, what's the beat?
You tell me, girl. I try to avoid the news as much as I can. Hypocrisy and fear-mongering, all of it. I could use some help, though.
What do you need?
Two of my birds have gone missing.
Mm-hmm.
I'd go look for them myself, but I've come to accept that I'm not as nimble as I used to be.
That is true.
What are you smiling at? Anyway, their locator beacons are still active. If you could find out what happened to them, I'd be grateful.
I'll find them for you.
Thank you. The first beacon is not too far from here.
The first beacon is apparently right there. Good man.
The beacon should be easy to locate. Just follow the increase in frequency. They're most likely dead, both of them. But at least you can recover the message capsules. Errato and Thalia always were easily distracted.
So it's somewhere in there, from the sounds of it. I'm getting closer. Who are you? You look like one of the specialists that I saw before. Maybe they aren't talking to me because I'm on a mission right now. Oh, okay. I need to get in there. That's where they are. I need to find a way in there though. How do I get in there? Okay. This game doesn't really always tell you where to go. Oh, poor birdie.
Found Arado. She's dead. Shot. I'm sorry.
I understand. Please take the message capsule if it's still there.
Oh, it's still here, alright.
Thank you. See if you can find Thalia.
Phew. So, Thalia, huh? Old friends, that is, yeah, Thalia, right. It's gonna take me right past, what's his name? Jack, I think? I forgot his name, but yeah. One of those guys there. I just love rerunning in this game. And one of the things about this game is that once your focus meter fills up, you'll actually start seeing colors move vibrantly. Like this thing, I don't know what that thing does. Maybe it summons the security bots on you, but yeah, it typically is looking straight at you.
I wonder if this means that Kruger Sek have caught on to my little postal service, or if they were just shooting them for sport. It's hard to find ways to communicate these days without half the world listening in. Maybe I should shoot some Kruger Sek for sport.
You found Irato dead, probably killed by Kruger Sek. Luckily, you did manage to recover a message capsule, and Birdman then sent you to find Thalia. Let him know when you do accept. Yeah.
Thalia found. Also dead. And the capsule is gone.
That's not good. She was coming in from Noridia Nova. Can you look around a bit?
Absolutely. Sure. I should have collected that first. Whoops, it was somewhere over there from the sound of it. No, we're not going downstairs. Upstairs.
Another runner was here.
Another runner? Well, maybe they have the capsule.
Who's this? That's a runner. Whoops, sorry. There's a capsule, but where's the runner though?
I found the capsule. That other runner hid it. Left a cabal mark I haven't seen before.
Well, I owe them thanks regardless. And you, Faith? Thank you. Now I need to train two new birds.
Messenger boots. The oldest way to communicate in this world. Now, are we gonna go back and... Oh, wait. Yeah. I'll just spend it quickly on quick skill roll. And, oh, that unlocks coil. Oh, we need to learn that. That's insane. Right, so are we headed to Birdman again? Like, we do need to return all this to him, right? I suppose not. Not really. We are done with the side missions for now. There's like this entire expansive world out here that we can explore. Excited to unlock it, really. Birdman's route. Yeah, I'm not really interested in Birdman's route. For now, let's just head over to that other kid there. Her friend. And, yeah. Old friend, meet with Nomad, essentially. So, with that being said, I severely apologize for the lag. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be picking things up from here. However, before I go, I would just like to comment a little bit on Mirror's Edge and Mirror's Edge Exordium. So basically, Mirror's Edge also had like a bunch of prequel comics to it. Not prequel, like prologue comics to it, which outlined the state of the world that Mirror's Edge was portraying. The story in that comic was actually quite different from... Well, the story of Mirror's Edge itself, but the things that it outlined actually felt like they had more depth to it. It was more impactful than the world of Mirror's Edge Catalyst. Over here, they're like just, you know, a bunch of people who are trying to survive, the runners, I mean, who are outliers, not a part of the citizenship program. They've traded in a place in society for freedom, essentially. But in Mirror's Edge, the original Mirror's Edge comic, they had a cause that they were fighting for, and that's pretty much the entire reason why Faith got caught up with Kreuger Sec, or rather, Piranteo Kreuger in that game, as it was called. And like her mom was actually a technological genius who had developed some technology, but enough about that. The thing about the Exordium comics is that it's lacking a bit of depth, and it just literally does the bare bones job of providing like a story for Mirror's Edge Catalyst. I did outline the story for you, and that's pretty much the gist of it, but it isn't really a bad read. So if you get the opportunity to do so, you should definitely pick up the comic and try reading the story for yourself. So yeah, with that being said, until next time, fare thee well, fellow earthlings.